Hello everyone and welcome on here to the next part. I believe this may be day 10 or day 11 of the Florida vlogs here for 2K18 but getting uploaded in 2019 because I'm so bad at uploading these. But here we are for the next again day on the Florida vlogs. I hope you have been enjoying them so far. If you haven't checked any out, please go ahead and check out the playlist. Or just go to my channel and check out the previous Florida videos. They've actually been really fun to make and really fun to watch. And, you know, it just takes me back to being there, and I hope you've been enjoying them as well. On today's part, we are going to be going back to SeaWorld. We're going to be doing some cool stuff where I get to have an experience with a walrus. Now that was a highlight of my trip. Sadly, I never caught on camera, so you are not going to see my experience with the walrus just because it probably would have ate you guys up there on camera. But it was very, very fun. I really enjoyed it. So if you want to find out more about the walrus encounter, guys, go ahead and check out my blogger site in the description below, where you can check out my experience with the walrus and how I felt experiencing being beside a walrus. It was actually quite a frightening experience. They're very big, very, very big. But one thing you did get to see me do was you got to see me encounter many different animals, one of them being a sloth. You guys know how much I love sloths. Well, I finally get to meet one here in this video. So that is why you guys should stay tuned for today's video. And if you do enjoy, guys, please smash the like button, show for your family and your friends, and subscribe so everyone can watch this, because if you're thinking of going to SeaWorld, maybe paying do the animal encounter may be something you guys are suggesting. So definitely stay tuned to see if I enjoyed it, which I really, really did. So, anyways, I'm gonna let you get away and I'm gonna let you watch this video, guys. Let's check out my social media links in the description because, you know, I need the followers. Anyway, guys, enjoy. Morning, guys, and we are here at SeaWorld. Not been here since last week, but as you can see, all the rides are over there. It's going to be a really good day as we're going to go on rides and do lots of stuff here, and then we'll go shopping and then head to Universal. It's going to be a busy day today. So, it's actually going to be the first day we've actually went to two different parks. Pretty awesome. Look forward to riding all those rides again. I've got a book that I'm going to be meeting the walrus later on today. I was being the animal ambassador with my sister and my mum. They're going to be meeting the beluga whale, but look at the little bird. Just like a stingray bit. A heron. Go further over on this side, we have to go over there. It's stingray pups in here. Oh. Wow. They're tiny. So you just saw the babies? Well, this is the size they grow up to. Wow.
Oh, they feel funny.
They're slimy. Hello. Yeah, they are quite slimy.
Touch your tails, they don't like you.
Oh, touch the fin.
Oh, Lauren just dropped her glasses in the bag.
Yeah, I put my glasses in the bag. I'm going
to secure here. Oh, Lauren. At least she got them.
At least it wasn't a deep pool.
Oh, they just headbutted each other. Don't you feel very, very weird?
Ew, I don't like the feeling.
Dolphin! For some of the name, oh, they're lovely. Stay close for that one. There was speed and time. They're jumping all around now. Oh, there she goes.
They're waving.
The jump again. Oh, very nice. Oh! Manatees and sea turtles thrive. They're not a blue planet. Oh. Never knew there was a queue to go see them. Ah, well. We're here now, and look at the size of those manatees.
Baby manatees.
Oh, they are baby manatees. Sea turtle in the other room. Baby alligators. Wow. Look how many there are. They're just living beside the turtle. I'm gonna put ahead onto our first ride here at SeaWorld today. Journey to Atlanta. That's not very happy. He doesn't want to get wet, but I'm forcing him onto it anyways. Woo! Better view. There we go. Oh yeah, baby. The ride is down at the moment, so that's very unfortunate. I'll go find something else to do so this cut. It's a 75 minute wait. What? So me and my dad are going to be doing this in a couple moments. And later on, my mum and my sister will be doing that one. Oh, look at cutie this. I'm going to touch a wall this because look at that eye. I want to see that eye. Hi! Oh yeah! One of the beluga's. The other one is away with my mum and my sister. She's still up for the close-up encounter. Fight going on. Oh! That one woke that one up and it jumped onto the ice. I think you lost. The Wallace earlier was so fun, so fantastic. Massive.
And this helps us share that connection with all of you. And what we learn from these dolphins here at SeaWorld creates an opportunity unlike any other, which is it allows you to experience these incredible animals up close. So, are you guys ready to have some fun and meet some of our dolphin stars?
Woo!
All right. Well, the first one I want to introduce you to is one of our top athletes. And he's coming racing around the front panes of glass. Say hello to Beretta! Now dolphins can spin up to 20 miles an hour, and he is showing that off perfectly. Now, just like you and I, dolphins need exercise too. It's just one of many ways to stay healthy. So these high energy or the high-flying aerials that you see are just some of the ways that these dolphins can stay in tip-top shape. Alright, next up we have Marble here is a great, he's laid back and he's even easy going, which makes him a great teacher. Now, who does he teach? Us! As newer trainers as we come here, we'll probably get to know and learn from Marble first. And he also knows some unique behaviors all to himself. Coming up at the center pool, here's Marble! Now, Marble is also a dolphin who really responds well to the relationships that he shares with his trainers. But we spent this one-on-one time. You really get to know them just as much as they get to know us. And that is so important, because when you build that strong bond and trust with them, that is the key when it comes to training and working with dolphins just like this. Nicely done, you two. All right, center stage here, we have one of our smallest dolphins. His name is Clyde, and he weighs 430 pounds. Now, being the lightest and the smallest dolphin doesn't mean anything, because he knows more aerial behaviors than any other dolphin here. But coming up in the center with this impressive backflip, it's Clyde! Woo! That's amazing, buddy! All right, last but certainly not least, over here on the far left-hand side, we've got Alejandro. Alejandro's a fun and unique dolphin who has a unique style of doing the majority of his behaviors. So here he is with his bow behavior. One more time in the center. There you go. And now Alejandro's also a dolphin who really loves playing with toys. And trainer Liz just threw in a boat buoy, which serves as a great toy for dolphins. We have a wide variety of things that we can provide to them. And we can give them these toys for various reasons, whether to reinforce or reward great behavior, or just to simply play with them. And by playing with them is another great way that you can build that strong bond and relationship with them that I mentioned earlier. Also, by interacting with them in different ways and changing little things up throughout the day, you can really keep these dolphins mentally stimulated, motivated, and make situations like this very exciting. As you can see, all these dolphins are very unique, so getting to know each of them is a huge part of what we do. And now, you guys know them just a little bit better too. So let's hear it one more time for some of our dolphin stars! All of our dolphins are very special to our entire SeaWorld family. As kids, many of us visited SeaWorld, and we sat in those very seats where we were inspired to want to learn more about the oceans and all of its amazing animals. And maybe even one day grow up to work and play with dolphins. So now, we would like to share what our dolphin days are like with all of you. Thank you.
do you think that might be? What do you think he uses to jump really high? His tail. He uses that tail like a big paddle as he swims, and that's what helps him jump all the way up and out of the water. Now I need your help asking Hill to jump out of the water, okay? So what we're gonna do is he's gonna watch you. You're gonna use your left hand and point it down like this to that hand, and it down like that, and then you're gonna draw a big check mark across your body, okay? So you're gonna point up to those trees. So just like that, that's the hand signal. Yep, so you point down and then point up. Ready? Phil's gonna watch you. We're gonna give him that hand signal on the count of three, okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3. Good! Now watch right there in the middle of the pool. Wow! Let's hear it for Phil! Chris has been an amazing junior trainer. So Phil's gonna say goodbye to you dolphin style. So come back over this way with me. We're gonna need everyone to help us with this one. Can you guys help us out?
Yeah.
Perfect. Ignacio, go ahead and stand here and turn around and face the audience for me. Just look up this way. What I need you to do is give Phil a big kiss on the count of three with me, okay? And then he's gonna say goodbye to you, okay? You guys ready? 1, 2, 3. Bye, Phil. Let's hear it for our junior trainer, Phil.
Must have stopped the riders of Manta. You can zoom right into their face. They're probably not enjoying it up there. Puts the orca walk around outside the water. That is not real, ladies and gentlemen. This is dolphins in training. There they go. Try to catch the ice. Hello.
He's just the cutest thing, isn't he?
Oh, he's flying!
Hello.
Hi. Yeah, too far ahead of you, didn't I? So Panama was a local rescue. He was found abandoned on his nest over on the... But pretty crazy feature. Some of these guys, they have a very sharp beak, but you can see he's pretty gentle when he interacts. That's because he knows me and likes me. I've been around him when he doesn't like somebody and it's a little different. But they do have a nice little hook on their beak. And then the interior, the upper part of this beak, it's almost like it's serrated.
Well, he's off again.
He just gets antsy. He's like a little kid. So he can only sit still for so long. Come on back. He's trained to know to look for this post. So this post travels with him wherever he goes, whether I'm in the park, if I take him into the park, or we go into one of our theaters, or he goes on TV. He's traveled, he's been
on the
show. Is he
okay in the park with like all the people? Or does he freak out if you take him?
No, he's usually fine. He's actually, like I said, I thought he was 8, but maybe he's older than that now. but he's been doing this for so long, he's really a ham. He doesn't mind people. He'll do what he's doing to you guys. And we just set up a barrier and we have a spotter with us. So he'll usually stay on his post and let people be around. When we do our shows in Nautilus Theater, the theater has a stage, but then it has a thrust that comes out on the stage. And so his post is usually set back and he'll jump down and he'll walk the thrust like it's a catwalk. And then he'll come back and he'll stare at people, like he'll come up to the edge and just look at them. And then he'll go back. So he loves to be animated around.
Oh, well done.
So I'm just looking for him to be. Yeah, it's the tail of a fish, so it's got to go down head first, but this one doesn't have a head on it. So he's going to fiddle with it for a minute until he gets it to go the right direction.
Weird. Oh, there we go.
Okay, we're going to walk this way and we're going to bring out our next guy. Come on.
Okay. Bye. Come on, Roland.
He's like, I'm going that way.
All right.
Before I let her hang out,
hello.
I guess we give her a nice pet rub down here on the lower back right above my hand.
Oh, cute.
Because this is going to be important later.
We have some pictures of them.
Oh my god, it's a snuff. Oh,
it's
so cute.
It's a snuff.
All right, so I'm going to let her hang out here.
So fluffy.
So this is Mila. She is a two-toed sloth. And the way you can tell, she has two toes on the top, on her front feet. The back feet have three. All sloths have three in the back. Again, she is a rescue. She is from Panama. She was rescued by an organization called the Pan-American Conservation. I keep wanting to say Panamanian. It's not. Pan-American Conservation Association. It is the largest rescue facility organization in Panama. And Mila here was found at a construction site on the ground. Super small, where she should have been the size that she was found at, she should have been with her parents still, and she wasn't. So they called in, and they came in, they picked her up, they took her back, did all sorts of tests and checks on her. She was totally fine, like healthy, nothing broken, nothing out of place, but she just was pretty much abandoned for whatever reason. And so they kind of took care of her for a while, trying to get her to the size and the weights and everything she needed to be. And they tried to re-release her back into the wild. When they did, she started making a lot of noise. And these guys don't make a lot of noise. So they brought her back in, tried to really release her leg. Not working. So she was deemed unreleasable, and they needed to find a permanent home, because since she technically was physically fit and healthy, the facility is not a permanent home. They're just a rescue rehab center. And we are also one of their conservation partners. So they called us and they said, we have this sloth. And we were like, yes. We didn't even hear the story. We're like, yes. But they did not want to just send her off to someplace out into the world, not knowing it, like been here. So when we said yes, they're like, good, we'll be there in 2 weeks. Their owner and head person, head animal person, came to SeaWorld, toured the park, toured our facility, toured across the street, Discovery Cove, saw everything, wanted to make sure that they were comfortable with where she was going to be staying. They liked what they saw. They said, great, we think this is great. We think this is a good fit. You guys... you guys look like you know what you're doing, so we'll gladly send her to. So we sent one of our trainers down there for about 2 weeks to learn how to take care of Sloss and learn Mila, and then brought her back. She's been with us for about 4 years, and she's one of our ambassadors. She does travel. She's actually going to be going to Philadelphia next week for an event. Yeah. So she's, all of our animals are trained to travel and trained to make appearances. That kind of stuff. Do you guys have any questions about it?
Is that the one that you sometimes take to Discovery Cove?
No, they have some. They
Lucy
and Lucky. Yeah, they have two over there. Those two were facility born, I think. Lucy, no, Lucky was the parent of one of the ones.
Yeah.
But they're also part of an SSP too. Mm-hmm. So they are part of that. So there are multiple animals across facilities that if they need to. We actually had, was it our sloth or our anteater that was the first cesarean? The anteater, never mind. Different animal, don't worry about it. But
bigger than you've been chasing. So I feel very smooth going down, but now take your finger and go the other way. And you'll understand why I wear gloves. It's very sharp. If I don't have the gloves on, I usually get like a rug burn or a scrape on my hand just from his feet, and his nails are also very sharp. So iguanas are found in South America. That's their natural habitat, rainforest areas, coastal areas. But this guy was found here on a local playground. One of our penguin keepers went to pick their daughter up from daycare, and the daycare director was like, you work at SeaWorld, there's a thing on our playground, take it back with you. And so he tried, but it ran up a tree, couldn't get a hold of it. And the next day we sent two people back to try and find it, collect it. But the school had already had somebody catch it, and they had it in an aquarium waiting to go with us. So, yeah. So they're a type of lizard that can lose their tail and regrow it. So if you see where the black lines end on his tail, right here, so that's where it ended when we found him. It was at that spot, and then he just grew that part back.
Now we've How long does it take for it to grow?
So it actually doesn't take very long for it to grow back. It was about a foot long after about short. Yeah, he wants to get down. So he comes out and he knows I always take him for walks. So he doesn't sit very well in my hands because he likes to walk. So this is what you call walking your lizard when you aren't putting him on the ground. You just keep rotating your hands until he stops, which he will in a second, but depends on how determined he is to go to the ground.
If he goes to the ground, would he run away?
No, he would just find a warm spot and usually just stop there and hang out. Eventually, he would, if I wasn't sitting here watching him, he would make his way up a tree or something like that. So I have a leash that I put on him when I take him walking in the park. I just have the leash on, because they can be really fast. So if something startles them, they're going to bolt and run, they'll scurry up a tree, and then I'll be here all night waiting for him to come in.
It's the best.
My anaconda don't, my anaconda don't, my anaconda don't go big bong
bun.
So we were supposed to be going to Universal, but we were doing too much at SeaWorld. Like, I was having really fun exploring the walrus, seeing the sloth and all that. It was a really good day, so we actually stayed right up to the end. And now we're just going to go out shopping and then go for some food. Yeah, I knew that was going to be too much to do in one day.
Not this time, you drove away from me this morning. Don't, no. I'm going to get in. Oh, come on. It's not funny anymore. Oh boy. I'm gonna get you. Really? Well, really? That is a huge cloud over there.
Drive for half a mile.
Wow.
This is gonna be stormy.
Hit and run sign. Or Simpsons hit and run sign. Oh, whoa. It's gonna rain down bad here. The rain is starting. It's the food court. I am hungry. Oh no, rain, go away. It is lightning outside. So mad. In my subway.
There's cones there.
Very good.
And
then... You want cones?
An M&M vending machine. Through the thunder. Whoa! Lightning. It's not just striking down though. Usually it is, but... Oh man. Thunder's so really loud. Just get in the shelter. Woo! Man. They're going. There we go, that's the fun that we're all loving. It's not Friday night. Oh man, it's our favourite song. It's our favourite song. He said there's a remix version of it. Got myself a pair of shoes. I got myself a pair of shoes. Oh yeah, I'm better than you. So this was a really eventful day today. I done quite a lot. I love meeting the walrus, love meeting the sloth and all of that. And I shopped till I dropped. So yeah, pretty good day. I'm quite tired. I'm going to go for a shower and I'm going to go to bed. And I'll see you all in the morning. Night night. So you have saw my encounter with the animals and found out probably one of the best days I had in Florida when I went in 2K18. This was a great video, guys. I loved every moment of this. So if you did too, guys, please smack the like button, show your family and your friends, subscribe and click the notification bell to never miss a future video. Check out the previous videos if you still have not, where you really, really should have. And check out my social media links in the description to stay tuned to my almighty face. And, well, check out my blogger site if you want a prediction on, or should I say a spoiler on, the next video is going to be. So the next video is of course day 11 and it will be going to Busch Gardens again. We go to Busch Gardens, have a more successful trip than the last time we went, and then we go out, do a little bit of shopping. I think we go to Steak and Shake that day. Brilliant place, I love that. And then we went away, far, far away from Orlando, a couple of hours away, and we went to Clearwater, and it was beautiful. The sand was so fluffy. But if you want to check out what I thought of Clearwater, then check out the next video coming to you guys in a couple of days' time. and you get to check out mighty Storm Florence, Hurricane Florence in her prime. So and so. But guys, we've not got that much left. I hope you're going to stick with me on the rest of this journey, and I will see you all later. Crazy. Time out. Bye bye. Love you all.